आत्मा एंड माइंड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस वेदर इट इज वन और डिफरेंट माइंड इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डिस्टर्बेंस इफ यू ट्राई टू कंट्रोल इट व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ आत्मा इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स सो एक्चुअली we are very commonly using the word atma but whether atma is existing or not what is atma the scripture says you have to know atma by atma ishu but it is not wrong it is correct the statement of our scripture is correct we can feel atma through atma alone mind cannot feel our senses cannot feel Atma alone can feel Atma. So that is absolutely correct. There is no wrong in it. But how relevant it is for our soul? So that is the question. So what is Atma, first of all? But in other words, instead of using the word Atma, we can use some other word. Instead of Atma, we can use some other word. We may hear the word awareness. चित दुरिया दुरिया चित अवेयरनेस विटनेसिंग एवरीथिंग इज आत्मा सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स डिनोट्स आत्मा आत्मा इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द नोइंग स्ट्रक्चर द कैपेसिटी ऑफ नोइंग इज आत्मा दैट इज चित चित मीन्स नोइंग चित सत् चित आनंदम सच्चिदानंदम that is the definition for atma sachit ananda sachidanandam is the definition for atma so that is sat means that is existing what is existing the knowing factor is existing some knowing factor that knowing factor is existing ananda is known as not that is a bliss that is not bliss Ananta is really mean Ananta. Ananda means indefinable. We cannot define Atma. We cannot define the Chit Amsa. We cannot feel the knowing factor. We cannot define the knowing factor. But the knowing factor is the basis of everything. For example, we are having tongue. With the help of tongue, we can taste many things. If we place a sweet, we can feel sweetness. But if you put some hot subject or some bitter object, the bitter taste will be there. Whatever put in the tongue, the taste will be expressed in the form of some taste. So if you do not put anything in the tongue, what will be the taste of the tongue? It is silent. But it has the capacity to know anything. But whenever we are giving some chance for the expression, we can have the expression of sweetness and bitter taste. But if you do not put anything, if there is no expression, the unexpressed form of our tongue is the Atma. That is the awareness. That is the basic structure. That is the substratum of our existence. So that is the awareness. But what we feel is known as consciousness. So consciousness alone we can feel. The taste is a consciousness. The bitter taste is a consciousness. The state of sweet is a consciousness. So what we feel is only our consciousness. That is the expression of the awareness. But we cannot feel the awareness. Awareness is the basis of everything. Without awareness, no consciousness is there. But without the tongue, no taste is there. The tongue, the original state of tongue is the awareness. And the awareness created the sensitivity, the consciousness. But here, the mind is the total cause for everything. So we need not connect the Atma to the mind or senses. Everything is possible only with the help of the Atma. So we cannot have a separate role for the Atma. Atma is the substratum of everything. one can attain nirvana about which the feet Mahavira or great Buddha or Buddhas speak, by staying in the state of witnessing Durya or Durya. So here, so the nirvana is not related to the Atma. Nirvana, enlightenment, liberation, everything is related to the mind, not related to the Atma. Atma is the substratum, it is for everything. We cannot separate the Atma from anything, it is for everything. Without Atma, even ignorance is not possible. Ignorance, understanding, everything is possible only with the help of Atma. Atma is the substratum of everything. Without Atma, nothing is possible. Right and wrong, everything is possible only with the help of, not only good thing, bad thing also possible only with the help of Atma. Atma is a substratum of everything. But we need not question the Atma. So all problem, all solution, everything is related to the mind. So the mind alone, but with the help of the Atma alone, the mind is functioning. So we cannot separate the Atma from anything. So that is from the basis of everything, Atma is there. So we need not worry about the Atma. The Atma and Durya is same. There is no difference between Atma, Durya, witnessing, everything is one. But here, the enlightenment is not related to the Atma. The enlightenment and the liberation is related to the mind alone. So you need not worry about the Atma and liberation and anything. So it is related to the mind alone. So many persons have not properly described what is enlightenment, what is liberation. Liberation is something different and enlightenment is different. Many persons are clubbing both and confusing the definition. So if you separate the enlightenment and liberation, it will become a science. So anybody can, but our work is over related to the enlightenment alone. We need not work for the liberation. Liberation is already there. You need not work for that. We have to work for enlightenment alone. Enlightenment is not a mystical experience, it is not a mystical knowledge. It is a simple knowledge that you have no power to deal with the liberation. You have no power to deal with the mind. So our intellect has the power to deal with all the things, all the duties of the world. Our intellect is necessary, helpful to deal with our day-to-day activities. But the intellect has no power to deal with itself. So we can use our mind for all our duties, but we should not use our mind against the mind. So that is a problem. So the mind has to understand it has no work against itself. So that is the enlightenment. If you understand like this, we will give total freedom to our mind for itself. So we can use our mind. If it is related to the external world, we can use our mind. But in itself, it has no work. That we have to find out. Today the questions are many, but we are, to the possible extent, I will try to answer all the questions.